I think Celebrity Food Bowl is really boring. They've had to like put celebrities in now because the usual ones.
No,
even worse.
They don't. They have like a normal Big Brother and then they have Celebrity Big Brother.
Because it gets
to, like,
boring and people get bored of normal people.
Sure, it's actually really fun. She doesn't know what she's talking about.
She forces me to watch it.
It's nice.
It's bad times. And what's even worse is when they have it live on E4.
Oh God, and then they lose the sound and then you're sat there for ages and just in silence.
Watching a duck outside.
We're in bed. What do they have in Big Brother?
I cannot stand Dead Set. It's too Resident Evil. The very first episode, too in your face, too quick getting the zombies in. They needed to leave the zombies out for an episode or two. It was absolutely horrid.
Last night, we both watched the Skins opening of this series. We thought it was pretty good, as it represents our college lives, kind of, but not as bad as that. And yeah, it was pretty good. Looking forward to the rest of the series.
Yeah, I was watching YouTube the other night, and I thought it was pretty average. Like, the content they have on the show, I think it's a good concept and idea about, well, like, yeah, getting the best of YouTube videos and etc. But what they actually chose wasn't that funny. Didn't really rate it that highly, to be honest.
I've been watching Darren Brown and I think he's amazing. He'll admit he's not a psychic, but he can just read people's minds pretty much just by the way they act. And it's just so cool to watch.
I watched Could You Eat an Elephant? And it really, really made me angry, even though I was transfixed and I had to watch it to the end. It absolutely made me livid.
Paul Burrell, What Really Happened? I watched it. I'm glad I watched it. I was a little bit disappointed. I felt that I found out more about this man than what I thought I did.
We've been watching Christianity, A History. We've watched the two programmes and, well, we both thought they were very, very good, didn't
yes,
we?
Yes, I found it useful because as a non-believer, I found that seeing an alternative view was quite good.
I just want to discuss the true cost of cheap foods, which was on Channel 4 last night. The programme started off really well and it was extremely well put together to give people indication of what sort of meats you could, no, proteins you had in sausages and various pies. And that programme really was quite an eye-opener for me. And thank you very much.
We all love Hollyoaks.
We all love Hollyoaks, basically.
Hollyoaks is the best.
Yeah. Bird's pretty nice. Standard. Not too good.
Especially Mercedes.
Yeah.
I like the storylines.
Yeah. Storyline's great. Watch it every day.
I watched that Half Ton Sun documentary and I just couldn't believe how the lad was so big at such a young age, but how his parents had obviously allowed it to happen over, you know, however amount of time. It's good to see, you know, true stories and how these situations happen.
My Name Is Earl is a show I'm very fond of. It's got some very good actors in it. Jason Lee, fantastic work he does. And it's a very good show. You can watch it in any mood you want. I particularly like it if I've had a rough day at work and I can put it on and just relax and watch it and it just makes me feel good again. It's got a really good vibe to it and a really good energy.
I think My Name Is Also a brilliant programme. I think Randy's one of the best characters I've ever seen on TV. I can laugh about him all day long. And I think the point behind it is good because obviously they're talking about karma. And, you know, I think from watching it, I believe karma's a good thing. What comes around goes around.
I think the new Countdown is very good. It's good to have the change and I think they do a good job.
I've seen the new Countdown. We like Countdown right from the very beginning. Unfortunately, the colours of the set really don't come out of the television in a very nice way. And also the girl that's introducing it on Carol's side of it, well, I'm afraid she's got no...
I love watching Time Team. It's a good programme. It's out people to learn about history and Roman times. And it's nice to see them digging up the old buildings to find what people used to live in.
Yeah, I saw Surviving Gazza, which was quite moving, really, considering you know, the life that he had as a professional footballer. But it was quite revealing into his children's lives and everyone around him. So, you know, I found it quite emotional to watch.
We've been watching Super Size versus Super Skinny and we absolutely love it.
I love what I'm seeing, how much one's lost and how much one's gained.
It's also interesting the fact that they go through like the medical conditions that you can have from being too overweight or too skinny and stuff like osteoporosis for the skinny people and obviously heart disease for the overweight people.
So I think it's like a warning for people watching it as well to think about their own weight and if they could be doing something themselves to change.
Recently we've watched Mum, Dad Alzheimers and me.
We think that the programme really highlighted the difficulties you have of gaps within care. One side of the care system not knowing what the other side's doing.
Yes.
The difficulty of knowing where to go, the difficulty of dealing with each stage of the disease.
We did find it very, very useful, didn't we?
Yes. Yeah.